I can't speak for the board, but what I can tell you is that I am committed to making sure that we are empowering those people who have relationship with our schools to be advocates for them.
Okay.
That's the best
thing to do. Now, Malachi, you want to ask another question? I saw your hands.
Just a comment. We have been doing this ritualistic pyre dance around some kind of a great fire ever since I was a little boy. And I'm 70 years old, and I have lived in this community since I was 4. And I've watched it and watched it and watched it. And every time one of these crises come up, we do this ritualistic dance around the fire. Everybody goes away feeling good because we've had these discussions. Meanwhile, our community, our children, the most vulnerable parts of our community keep falling further and further down that cliff. And we keep watching our communities, mostly black, mostly low income, fall further into degradation. And yet we spend huge amounts of dollars and tout great programs about how to do this, and yet we are no better now than we were when I started Fairview Elementary School in 1948.
He's back.
There's something, it's something that we can do that we ain't doing.
But could it be the curriculum? Could it be time for change?
Doing the same thing.
Let's let Malachi finish, and then we're going to have to get out of here.
We got to get off this dime.
That's the second part of the question.
We have got to get off this dime. Otherwise, when I'm dead, and when we all are dead, we're going to have our offspring sitting in this room stalking the same question. It's time out for it. That's all I'm going
to
say.
All right. And what I'd like to say is, Malachi, I'd like to challenge you. It would do my heart good to know that the offspring would be able to sit in this room and have this conversation. I don't feel that confident today. And the reason why I don't is because I don't know what we're missing as well. I mean, I have very close friends who have tremendous means, far more than my parents or my grandparents, but their children are illiterate. Their children are emotionally bankrupt. And I believe, in my little short span of life here, that it is all about the exposure to these kinds of experiences and people that can show them what it looks like to move forward. We've not painted the picture of what success is because we've colored that to be so many things, and not about a mindset, not about an approach. One of the things that is so, one of the task forces is the Higher Education Partnership. And in that conversation with all the leads of the universities locally, one of them said, you know what, in our freshman classes, the number one question, now they're already in college, they got in, so we got it, right? Yay, they got in. The number one question of all freshmen is that going to be on the test? Is it in the book? Now, they're in college. So to your point, it is all about what are we doing to expose them, not necessarily all to the academic part, but to what it means to actually understand an issue and push through it. And I believe that that is the work of this department. It is the work of this community to begin through relationship and through exposing them to people who have experiences like yours, like everyone in this room. Our kids don't have that. We don't spend time telling them about that. They don't know what it is, right? I had a good friend of mine who gave her daughter $5 and told her to put it in the gas tank. And the girl said, this is a smart, she's going to college. She says, how do I pay for gas without the card?
Okay.
So I say that to say we have got to really take a step back and ask ourselves as individuals, what are we sharing? What experiences are we sharing with all, not just the poorest of the kids, but all children, so that they're able to not be here again?
LaTarzja, thank you so much.
Yay.
Here you have someone who is here, who is saying that if you have something that you want to present to her, she is open to hear, not to say that she's accepting it, because some of it is, might be valid, some might not, but at least say it. I mean, I'm sure LaTarzja will give you her email address. This is your opportunity. I constantly hear that you, as African Americans, you don't your organization is not considered for things, that you have to pay to play, and all of these things. You know, we're trying to look at these things and we're trying to say, how can we all come together to work together and give other people opportunities? LaTarzja, I'm sure you'll share your email address, but you know, we talk and then we leave and then we come back and talk and then we leave. Let's present it to her.
I want to say thank you. And thank you. And thank you, and thank you. And I don't need to say very much, because if I say much more, then I'm gonna break up.
We got to hang
on. And I don't need that.
Well, all right.
But now let me tell you, this young lady, I've had the opportunity to get to know her through years of working with CMS, and I know her work. She is as dedicated a person as I have ever seen to the welfare future of those young people that we've got, that we've entrusted to their care. I also need to say this, that it's up to us.
Yes.
It is up to us. It's up to us.
Amen.
Not CMS.
Mm-hmm.
Not the Board of Education.
Amen.
To make sure that our school system functions as it does. And yet sometimes I think we sit on the sidelines and throw rocks as opposed to getting in there helping. Now it's time for us to get off our duffs and say, this is our community. The Charlotte-Mecklenburg school system is our system. It's not the school board system. It's not the superintendent's system. Mm-hmm. It's ours. And if we don't do it, Lord knows it ain't going to happen.
Amen. Amen. Okay, that's it.
Thank you all, and thank you all for all your expressions.
All right.